And today we're in the Plunkett Heritage Cooperative Museum. And this is a recreation of the museum that would have looked been here in 1889 when the first cooperative creamery set up. And we're in the engine room, and I'll just show you the two main factors of the engine room are the boiler and the steam engine. And the boiler worked the same principle as a pressure cooker. We had a tank of water here, which was heated using coal or good quality turf or wood, and that would have created a great pressure of steam as it heated up the water. And the steam would have been coming around this pipe here. The pipes are marked up red for hot water or steam, white for milk, and blue for cold water. In this room, we've only got the two colours, the blue and the red. The steam would have been coming into the steam engine, which is a 6 horsepower external combustion engine, which equates to 30 horsepower internal combustion engine. And as the steam would have come through, it would have pushed this piston out, which would have caused the iron wheel to move the belt, which there's a red drive shaft with the whole way the length of the creamery, and it would have brought all the machinery would have been run off that drive shaft. To ensure that it's a smooth movement and actually that the arm would come back, it had this balance wheel, which meant when the arm was fully extended, it would have been turning this wheel, would have pulled the arm back. But as the arm was fully extended, the steam would have been released and the arm would have been as far out as it would go. This way it would ensure there was going to be a cycle. There was a governor here, which was a very important factor in an engine. It ensured the steam wasn't coming in spurts. It ensured a constant flow of steam.